Hi everybody, Anthony here with Aces Adventures, and welcome to the Wonderland of the Americas in San Antonio, Texas, just on the outskirts of San Antonio, Texas, but we'll call it San Antonio, Texas. This is a mall, two things. Number one, that I filmed over May of last year, and wasn't sure how I was going to approach this video, and then just got busy with summertime. So this has been sitting in the vault for quite a few months now, but here we are, and here I am to tell the story. Now, first thing I want to say first, so warning alert, this typically, or technically, is not a dead mall in terms of its occupancy. It's doing very good, which I'm going to explain in a little bit, but in terms of its original purpose and what we would consider to be a regular shopping mall, it's completely dead in the fact that it's surviving in a very awesome and unique way, but in terms of being a traditional mall, it is definitely not that for the most part, albeit except for a very few amount of stores and the anchors. It's pretty much been converted into a cultural center with several offices and a very large Hispanic-based flea market given the proximity to Mexico, which was pretty cool. It was definitely a quite awesome experience. So I just wanted to preface that I have this video labeled as a dead mall. So in the sense of what I do, it is definitely a dead mall. But this property has some pretty interesting history, and I'm going to go over it right now. So this mall actually had a few name changes. It was supposed to originally be called the Wonderland City, and it was for a little while, and eventually was turned into the Crossroads Mall before becoming the Wonderland of Americas. This property, like I mentioned, has a ton of history, and it actually goes back over 60 years, so pretty crazy, 20 years older than I am myself. So getting into it here, this mall was opened on September 14th, 1961, was the first day of operation. At the time, it delivered 650,000 square feet of air-conditioned shopping, which was a big deal back in the day, a Handy Andy supermarket, and a two-level Montgomery Wards. Now, 2 years prior to the mall opening, the Handy Andy actually opened pre-mall in 1959, and the legendary John Wayne was on hand for the ribbon-cutting ceremony of the supermarket. The mall in 61 also featured a Woolworth, a Kinney's Shoes, a Zales, a Sinclair service station, and 5,000 parking spots. The mall began to grow just 2 years after opening with another 155,000 square feet Rhodes Brothers department store and a Wonder Theater. The mall would go on for about 20 years and then see its next set of upgrades in 86-87, as it was at the time renamed the Crossroads Mall. A new wing was added, and Anchor Steinmark was also added. A funny thing to mention, too, is Steinmark actually, here in the Buffalo area where I'm from, didn't come around until like the late 2000s, and actually, I had never heard of Steinmart until it opened, so it's funny how some anchor chains, when you travel the country, you're like, oh my gosh, these places have been around for forever. And by the way, before getting back into my spiel here, this is one of the areas that was converted from a former anchor space, I believe, into kind of like a gaming, pool, skating thing, so it's really cool that they tried to do something for the community and keep this place going, and by the looks of it, they're doing a very good job, so kudos to whoever owns this particular space here. So, but the funny thing is that even though in the late to mid to late 80s, this place would receive a typical upgrade, it was soon going to be facing some pretty serious challenges. The Frost brothers, who own one of the large anchor stores, filed for bankruptcy, and the downward spiral seemed to rapidly accelerate. And by the end of 1990, just 3 years later, the mall was over 50% vacant, so pretty rapid downturn there. The mall would transition there soon thereafter from a high-end center to that of value, adding places like Burlington Coat Factory and Hobby Lobby. Shout out to Hobby Lobby, I actually like that place. And then in 2002, the Wards was demolished shortly after their abrupt closure as a company, and that space was no longer there. So as you can see, it was a very rapid turn of events. And lastly, I just want to add that the mall was also involved in something rather odd and tragic. In the early 60s, there was a contractor who was working on the elevator, and he got stuck in the elevator shaft, I believe, and unfortunately the elevator started operating, and the man was decapitated. So pretty gruesome stuff there, and in the years after, several workers have claimed that the elevator in that exact same elevator, which is still there to this day, moves from its own on its own from time to time, and some have even reported seeing apparitions in the service hallways. So if you're roaming around that mall at night, keep an eye out for some extracurricular activities. So this place is great. I came down here on Memorial Day weekend. I had never been to San Antonio before, and actually after I filmed this mall, I ended up going on to film the video I put out a while ago on the Sunrise Mall in Corpus Christi. So this being at the bottom of Texas, pretty far down there to get to. So, but the funny thing is, as we're walking through this portion here, there are all these little vendors, and like I said, from an occupancy standpoint, the mall is doing well, like very well, and it's thriving in its own ways. But again, as a typical mall, it's not what we would expect from a typical mall. It's more of a community center, I would say. And I did walk around and try to speak to some of the vendors at the Spanish market. As you can imagine, a lot of them spoke Spanish, and I do not for the most part. They seemed to be very happy, and there was a great sense of community here. So it was definitely a cool place to see. And the aesthetics are very, very good. There are, I would say the food court is probably the most original looking part from the 80s anyways, you know, in terms of the era that I'm used to and have a big fondness for, with the neon and all that fun stuff. So definitely a cool mall to see. If you are ever down in Texas, I highly recommend checking it out. They have a couple great stores, like this Flashback Video Games and a couple other stores. As I mentioned in the last video, nostalgia is hot. Nostalgia is very hot right now. If you go into malls today, a lot of the stores like Hot Topic and Lunchbox, they are big on stuff from really my generation, the 80s and 90s, that is very popular. Nintendos are hard to come by now, and things like that. So it's great to see, you know, my era and the good old days, as a lot of us millennials like to call it, still prevalent. So that's really about it. That's all I have to say, really. I'm going to let you guys enjoy some music. By the way, that song that you heard in the opening, as I often do, stupidly, to my own dismay, I tend to sacrifice making any money on these videos because I use music that I just feel fits right, and I don't care if it's copyrighted, meaning that I just don't make any money on it. It gets demonetized. I would rather preference or sacrifice money for a good-sounding tune. But anyways, the song that you hear is from the 2006 movie Miami Vice, one of my top five all-time favorite movies. And when I'm making these videos, I just, for some reason, I don't, you know, maybe being a DJ and a musician for so long, a song just pops into my head and it just fits right and it goes with it. So hopefully you enjoyed that tune there. And if you ever have time, if you have not seen Miami Vice from 2006, great, great movie with a superb soundtrack. So good to be back. I told you guys I'll be putting out videos more often, and here's two in just a few weeks already. I'm going to try to get out just briefly here to some places. There is a mall in Arkansas that I want to visit, and I'm really feeling the itch to... you know, to get out and film again. We'll see if the algorithm shows me love. We'll see if you guys come back around. My channel is, you know, not one of those that does clickbait stuff. I just kind of am true to myself and promote it as best I can when I have time. So those of you that are here and want to see it, cool. If not, cool. Either way is fine. I just appreciate you showing up. Please consider following me on Instagram at AcesAdventures1. I do post on there all the time and interact with folks on a daily basis. Please consider becoming a Patreon donor. $5 or less, no more, please, at patreon.com/AcesAdventures. All that money goes towards expenses. Myself being a smaller channel, any little bit helps. So thank you so much for watching. I hope you guys enjoy the rest of your weekend, and we'll be back soon with more mall content.